off for my, and then for scoring purposes, there's actually a lot of decisions that can be made when you score. And I think that remembering that every loaf is a little bit different, and well, every loaf is different, but on top of that, if we're working from white to wheat, what's gonna happen once you score the bread is also slightly different. I mean, the same theories apply, like, but your white loaf, again, there's endosperm and germ interrupting these gluten strands. The bounce, the volume you're gonna get from white flour, you're always gonna get, unless you, I mean, if something is properly fermented, you're always going to get a higher loaf with a white loaf, which would require a slightly larger score. With a wheat loaf, you may need to do a slightly smaller score to maintain a similar volume. So I think about the exterior of the bread as sort of this support system for what's going on inside. So for this loaf, I would score, for this loaf, I'm gonna score it all the way down and around. And I'm gonna actually score fairly deep because this guy is gonna just go wild. He's gonna get really, really big. But for my whole wheat loaf to get a similar volume, instead of going with one big score, I'm gonna go with two smaller scores. And I'm not gonna go quite as deep. And the reason for that, now you can see inside the dough looks great. And I can cut another one open so you can kind of see the dough structure better. But the dough looks great. I can, and I'm always assessing that. When I cut, when I score my loaves before I put them, the very first loaf I score is gonna tell me so much. So it's important to slow down enough to say, what's happening in this loaf? I don't wanna mindlessly score 100 loaves. I wanna score one loaf. I want to see what it's like, and then I want to go on to the score the next loaf and the next loaf, because each loaf is an opportunity to do a little bit better, to learn a little bit more than the loaf before. So what I'm observing with this guy is I see